Okay, there is a problem. You simply read that problem and I will explain only that figure. So see, here there is a pipe and here is another pipe. Okay, and this pipe is connected with a limb of a U-tube manometer. There is a U-tube manometer. It is connected with this one. Okay, and this pipe is also connected with another U-tube manometer. But you see, the right limb of this U-tube and left limb of the second U-tube is connected with another inverted U-tube. Okay, so there are two normal U-tube as well as inverted U-tube is connected here. Based upon this connection, you have to find out the pressure difference between PA and PB. Okay, suppose this, the middle U-tube is not here, the middle inverted U-tube is not here. How we can say there is a reference line like this? You can simply say that in the left side, that is PA plus rho 1 into G into 108, that is in the left side. What will be the right side? PB plus this height into rho 1 into G, rho 1 into G plus 0.6 into rho 2 into G into 0.6. Okay. If this is not here, if the middle U-tube is not here. Okay. And if the middle U-tube is connected invertedly, so we have to apply that inverted tube differential manometer concept. So according to that, you please check one by one. At a point, so this is the reference line here. This is the reference line here. And there is another reference line, it is here. And see, the both pipe, that is PA, both pipes is having the same liquid. Say it is water. And the manometer, this manometer is having, that is normal differential manometer is having another fluid with the density rho 2. And this inverted U-tube differential manometer is having another liquid which is having the density rho 3. Okay, I think the concept is clear to you. So if it is so, we can say that at point 1, pressure is PA. At point 2, the pressure is PA plus 1.08 into rho 1 into G. Okay, and as the reference line, this is the reference line, this pressure will be equal to the pressure at P3. Therefore, P3 is equal to P2. And from P3, you see there is a differential inverted U-tube differential manometer concept. Therefore, the pressure at P4 is equal to P3 minus rho 2 into G into point, I think it is 92 or 72, whatever may be, you check it. Okay, that's the concept. And on seeing this reference line, you can see that P4 is equal to P5. P4 is equal to P5. And also from here, another normal differential manometer is starting. Therefore, the pressure at P6 is equal to P5 plus, what is the value of P5? That P5 is equal to P4. Okay. Then P5 plus 0.48 into P5 plus 0.48 into, here you can see that another, here it is, another fluid is here. Another manometric fluid is here. Therefore, P5 plus rho 3 into G into 0.48. Okay. Then, so P6 is equal to P5 plus this one. Then you can see that from this reference line, P6 is equal to P7. P6 is equal to P7. What is the value of P7? That we simply know. What is that one? This PB plus, you find out this height. With respect to these two values, you find out this height. Okay. So PB plus rho 1 into, rho 1 means that in both the pipe is having the same fluid. That is why I am taking rho 1. So PB plus rho 1 into, you find out this height. That into that is PB plus rho 1 into that height, rho gh. Okay, that plus 0.6 into rho 2 into g. Okay, so with all these relations, you have to find out what will be PA minus PB. Now I will show you the concepts on my, so pressure at 1 PA, pressure at 2, you just read the relation. What will be the pressure at 3, what will be the pressure at 4, what will be the pressure at 5, then 6, 7, 8 is indicating. But I have already said that when it reaches P7, you simply write P7 is equal to PB plus this one. Okay. Not that P7 is equal to P6. You find out that P6, you get all those things. And finally, you can simply calculate what is the pressure difference between these two pipes as PA minus PB. That also you have to check and solve the problem by yourself. Okay.